Hi guys, it's Katie from Team Lucky Little Learners here with another quick tips video. And this week I'm going to count down 13 ways you can use these little things to keep your students excited, engaged, and learning. Let's go. Idea number 13, use it to study words. This could be all sorts of different phonics or grammar skills you are working on currently. One of my favorite ways to use plastic eggs is a word family twist. So I'm going to write the word family. I'm doing the at word family this week. On the bottom half of the egg and different consonants or consonant blends on the top half, and students can simply twist it to make new words. Another way you can use this is a parts of speech sort. So here in this activity, I used just nouns and I had my students sort by person, place, or thing. You could also do noun, verbs, and adjectives for this. You could also try using prefixes and suffixes and root words written on different halves of the eggs. Idea number 12 is story writing, and this is a really fun and engaging get kids up out of their seat activity. To start with, I would have 2 to 3 eggs per student and hide them either around my classroom or outside on the playground, whatever works best for you. Have your students find their 2 to 3 eggs and bring them back to their desk. Once they're back at their desk, they're going to open them up and they have to use those words in their story. I use spring-themed vocabulary words. Like I said, this gets kids up out of their seat, a little nice break, and works on writing skills. Idea number 11 is to have a science of reading aligned egg hunt. This activity taps into phonics and phonemic awareness skills, and the students once again are up out of their seats, enjoying walking around the classroom, playground, schoolyard, wherever you've hidden your eggs. They open up the eggs and complete the task on their recording sheet. This one I like to do with partners. Idea number 10. Use these little eggs to study your vocab words. There's a couple different ways you could do this. You could put your vocab words in the eggs, hide them around the classroom, and then as students find the word, they either match it to a definition on a worksheet or write the definition, or do it vice versa. A third variation is to fill half of your eggs with your vocab words, the other half with the definitions. Have each student find one egg, and after each student has found their egg, they open it up and silently try to pair up with the right word or definition. The bonus of this activity is then afterward, you can have the students put the strips back in the eggs, hide them somewhere, and then they will repeat the activity. Idea number 9 is to practice compound words. And I gave this one its own category because it is just so much fun. What I did was write half of a compound word on one half of the egg and the other half on another half, and I kept the halves of the eggs separate and hid them all around the classroom. Students had to find one half of the egg and then see if they could match up with a student that had the other half of their compound word. A way to make this a little more tricky is to write the compound word halves on different colored eggshells. Number 8 is expanded form. As you can see in this picture, we have the expanded form of a number written on one half of the egg and the standard form written on the other. Students pair them up and practice expanded form on their work mat. Idea number 7 is to play coin scoot. So at each student's desk, put an egg with some money in it. What a great way to work on coin skills. Really quick before I move on, I want to tell you in the description is a link that leads to a $1 trial for our teacher membership site. All Access is our membership site with over 20,000 resources that are available just to click, print, and teach. We've done the heavy lifting for you. You get to do the fun part. Number 6 is to have a math review egg hunt. Similar to the science of reading one, you're going to hide these eggs around your classroom. Students open them and complete the little task cards. Idea number 5 is to practice fractions with eggs. There are a couple ways to do this. The first one is to write numerators and denominators on different parts of the eggs, and the students can spin the egg around, creating different fraction combinations. Another way is to put some sort of small object in the egg. This could be jelly beans, and they'll write the fractions that they find in the eggs. Here is an example. Number 4 is to have a stem egg drop. And unlike a traditional egg drop where the egg will splatter open if not protected well enough, the goal of this egg drop is to not let the plastic egg roll out of the vessel the students create. So use materials you can find in your classroom cupboards, coffee filters, pipe cleaners, felt, construction paper, whatever you have. Have the students work in a team to secure their egg in the middle and then drop it from a height and see if the egg successfully is held in place. Idea number three is map skills. So if you've been working on compass rose directions, this is the activity for you. Inside of these eggs, I have different map prompts for this map worksheet. Students open the egg and complete the prompt. You could also have this be a movement activity. Hide eggs around the classroom based on these directions. So in the first egg, it could say, walk 3 steps north. If the students walk the correct direction, there would be another egg hidden in that area and so forth. You may have to do a prize in the last egg for that one. Idea number two is another social studies idea. If you've been working on American symbols, this is a great way to review. Hid these symbols and eggs around the classroom and gave my students a list of the ones we had worked on that week, and they simply checked them off when they found it. Our last idea is one to help with your behavior management. It can be used the whole month before or after, or just that time around Easter. To prepare for this idea, you're going to fill a Easter basket with eggs, and inside the eggs could be different prize incentives, lunch in the classroom, an eraser, a sticker, prize box, candy, whatever it is that works for your students and that you have on hand. Every morning you will secretly select a student, and then throughout the school day remind the kids, oh my gosh, my extra special student is having a little trouble staying on task. I hope everyone can get on task so this student earns their prize. This works like a charm. I hope 1, 2, 3, or all 13 of these ideas give you ways to incorporate seasonal fun while keeping your kids learning. We'll see you next week. Now, check out these two videos and be sure to hit like and subscribe to never miss our teaching tips and tricks.